Hi guys, Katja here, and welcome to my YouTube channel. And today I will share with you art journal spread. And you see here three books in the Art Daily collections. And I do a little bit different stuff in them. And today you see here one I have done small pieces, like almost like inches. And this one, it's about me, and today I will do a spread about me. And yes, I have a very fantastic thing. It's a small mobile zip printer. So I use an application, and I will print a photo of a skirt I bought in December. And this small mobile printer, it prints photos 2 by 3 inches. It's perfect to my iPhone, and I think this is perfect to have with you when you go traveling or go to some events or something, and you want to keep a memory and do it. And the size, I think, matches my book perfect, and it's very handy and it's easy to use. And you see, you can put it in your handbag and take it with you. So I have some different pictures to choose from, but I think I will have two photos today in my art journal spread. And you see me go around a little bit to see how I will do the composition. I haven't decided really what I will do yet. I will let it go. I know I will glue two pages with each other, because if I use too much paint, it will go to the other side. And here I will use soft gloss gel, and I do a thin coat, thin layer of the gel, and stick two pages together. I don't want to destroy the previous page here. So, yep, and I stick two pages more, and I don't have too much of the medium. So it will go quickly, and the page will dry, stick together and dry. And you see, I have a brayer, so I use a little bit, and so I have the pages flat. Now I will prime my pages before I do anything. And you see, I'm thinking about the composition, and I will do something. I don't have the idea what I will do when I start. I let it come. And I have only a thin coat of gesso here, and I dry it. And I found some yellow printed book pages in handy, so I'm thinking of to use them because they matches my skirt a bit. So I'm thinking how to place them to have some background color on my page. And I will glue my torn paper. I use the soft material here also. And I'm checking sometimes with my photos. And you will notice in the end that my paper in the background will not show so much. But that's a process of mixed media. You never know how the end will be. And that's a fun thing about it. And here I have a small piece because I want to have a flow in the colors over the two pages. Yeah, and now I have some white gesso, and I have a thin coat only around the edges and basic where the glossy have been, because I haven't decided how what kind of paint I will have. So I do soft edges to my paintures. And when I was working, I had some paint laying on my table, and I have started with the Mediterranean blue impasto paints from Finnaber and Prima. And I use a spatula, and I let it come. And you see the background is already disappearing. I dry a little bit, and then I take the next color. I think it's crimson. It's pretty pink. And I don't take so much, and I do it a little bit randomly and dry it before I take the next color. I want to tone it down a little bit, so the impasto paint, the pastels, and I think it's the color, what it can be, the color boudoir pink. I tone it down. Yes, it's some pink on my photos because I want it to match. I dry it again. I dry it again, and I'm thinking to have a little bit more contrast. So I will take black impasto paints, and I do some lines also with the spatula, totally randomly and not so perfect. I only let it go like that. I think it's a little bit too much colors. So I want to tone it down a little bit. So I had the brayer lying. So I take some white, guess a little bit on the brayer, and do it all over to tone it down a little bit. This is not was not my plan. So only to tone it down, and you see, I go with the brush also around it. Oh, it's I have a stencil, and I think its name Passiflora, and also modeling paste. So I want to give the page little bit texture, and also a little bit contrast and pattern, and this is perfect because I think now the page and the stencil made it go together. And here I have some stamps from the Art Daily collection. The collection of stamps, it's called Carte Postale, and I'm stamping randomly. I love stamping like that randomly, so I pick some stamps, and here I have a stamp. It says moment, because it was a moment when I was trying my new skirt and took a photo of myself. So I think that's a moment from December. Stamping the word here and there. Now I have a small bottle with a fine tip. I have black gesso in it and water. Now I do scribbles. Yeah, I'm writing some autumn journal words. You can't really read it, but I know it says something there. I think that's make some extra interest to my page. So I dry it, and now I leave my page to dry a little bit more. And now I have picked some stamps from the set, and there is a hand and a posing lady. So I think those two will be perfect for my spread. Yes, and my stamping hand and my stamping lady, I fussy cut them, and this time I have only been stamping them. I was thinking about to emboss them, but I was changing my mind. And here I use distress ink to ink the edges a little bit more with the black to make them more soft. And these photos from the printer, yes, they are so easy to use because they are with double-sided tape on the back side. So it's so easy. And here I plate them on a black cardstock to frame my photos a little bit. I have some cheesecloth. I think I will have some behind my photos a little bit, like extra detail. And I have some foam tape when I glue my photos on the page. I think it make it more interesting and make a depth to a page when you have a little bit distance from the back side. Yeah, I'm gluing the cheesecloth on the page. Not so that perfectly, a little bit randomly. That's make more interest to the page. And also my hand and my small lady, posing lady from the Carl Postal collection. And also them are I'm gluing on small foam tape. Yes, and the hand needs also a little bit of the cheesecloth to make more interesting. Okay, the collection Art Daily also have some epoxy paper clips, and I also add that to my page. They are gorgeous. And here I have some glass glitter in some golden shade, and I can't resist to have some glitter on the page. I think that makes some interest to the pages, and I'm a glittery person very much. Now I have the Art Daily sentiments. I pick some sentiments. Dare to be powerful, yes. And there are so many wise sentiments and so encouraging sentiments you can take with you. So I love the sentiments. They are so perfect in many of the kind of projects. I want to frame my pair sentiments with a black pen because I think they match my spread better. Okay. Now in the end, I'm thinking to adding splatters, and you see me adding a few splatters. I think I have a black mist of some brand. I don't remember. And this is my page, and hope you enjoy it. And see you in the next tutorial. Welcome back. Bye bye.